Joe and Micah, stunning developments today as R. Kelly is charged with 10 counts of aggravated criminal sexual abuse. And we were here just within the hour when he surrendered to police. Watch this. R. Kelly, what do you want to say to your fans? Flanked by security guards, R. Kelly got out of the black Mercedes van just after 8 o'clock tonight, saying not a word as he walked into the 1st District Police Station, where he was placed in handcuffs.
Mr. Kelly is strong, he's got a lot of support, and he's going to be vindicated on all these charges.
Earlier today, Robert Kelly was indicted before a Cook County grand jury on 10 counts of aggravated criminal sexual abuse involving 4 victims.
Cook County State's Attorney Kim Foxx had a brief press conference today outlining the new charges against R&B superstar R. Kelly. She says the abuse happened between 1998 and 2010, and 3 of the 4 victims were underage. A judge issued the warrant for Kelly's arrest this morning.
Well, I couldn't have much interaction with anyone other than Robert.
The docuseries Surviving R. Kelly revealed some of the faces and stories behind allegations that have followed him for decades. Last month, Fox made a rare public plea for more victims to come forward, and they did.
We failed young black women in Chicago for 30 years.
Jim DeRogatis and Abden Palish are former Sun Times reporters who first broke the story more than 18 years ago. Kelly was later charged with child pornography, but a jury acquitted him in 2008.
Had the trial, the judge made some different rulings, the trial been handled better, there are a whole lot of victims who would not have been victimized.
In 2017, 2 women launched the Mute R. Kelly movement, leading to canceled concerts across the country, including here in his hometown of Chicago. And under mounting pressure, Kelly's record label dropped him.
Nobody in the history of popular music has been a predator with a track record of 30 years and 48 women whose names I know. So you ask the question, how many more?
R. Kelly due in Cook County Bond Court tomorrow afternoon. You'll hear much more from his attorney coming up on the news at 10. For now, reporting live from the 1st District Police Station, Gaynor Hall, WGN News. Back to both of you in the studio.